Welcome to Pomegranate and Pearls. Come on in. Just so you know, your goodie bags are here for your way out.
And you get recipes. If you're not paying attention tonight, how to open a pomegranate. A coupon for a free palm juice.
Yay! Yay!
And a pomegranate. Here we have the pomegranate mojitos. Okay, so the best way to make mojitos is with fresh mint. Fortunately, I have a whole wall of mint. Saves me a lot of money, and gosh, is it fresh. So we're gonna get a nice, big, hearty bunch of it to put in our mojito syrup, which I'll show you how to make in a minute. Okay, so I have a bunch of clean, fresh mint here, and what I'm going to do is put it in a mixture of lime juice and sugar that has been dissolved. And you probably had this at a bar before where they muddle it in the glass right there in front of you, but it probably you're picking mint leaves out of your teeth and that's not any fun. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna make this really wonderful lime mint tea. We're gonna kind of I'm using a pastry blender here to kind of muddle it up and to get the oils out of the mint. And then we're gonna let it sit for a couple of hours to really get the mint flavor infused into the lime juice. And then we're gonna strain it off and we're gonna have this wonderful liquid that we can mix with our rum and our pomegranate juice, and it also freezes really well. So if the mint's in the off season, you can go to your freezer and have it all done. So we're doing a double batch here because we've got 8 people coming and it's a party. Don't mind if I do. It's made with lime juice that we made up earlier. It's infused with mint, and we let it soak for a couple of hours, and then we strained it off, and we also have pomegranate concentrate in there, and we have club soda as well. So, and rum. Cheers. Let's see what's going on over here. Okay, we've got the fun going on in the kitchen. We've got pomegranate juice everywhere. So in a couple minutes, the guests are gonna arrive. Let me go ahead and get ready. You don't have to do this, but I find it's really helpful because then if the juice runs, it doesn't go all over the counter. So I'm going to cut this into eighths. Yeah, we already had the situation today with it.
At least it's red.
And that's the red tonight. Okay, we're going to put the pomegranate pieces into water because it's going to make it a whole lot less messy to get them out.
Oh, Mom.
So, when we're all at the table, I can tell you how funny a pomegranate is.
Okay. Oh, and the story of pomegranates, we found out from Jackie, our History of the English Language master. Palm means apple, and the granite part means garnet because of these little garnet seeds. So there's your history lesson for the day.
Do you want another little bit of useless information regarding pomegranate?
We do.
Get to her with her useless information regarding pomegranate.
In Australia, we call English people Poms, and there's word going around that there's many derivations of why they call them Poms, but one of the things was when they came over on the boat from England as a convicts, they fed them pomegranates to alleviate scurvy.
Did not know that. So there's a lot of vitamin C in pomegranates.
Yes. Lots of vitamin C.
And there's a lot of vitamin C in those mojitos too because there's lime juice.
I know. What are you doing here?
Okay. Here's what I'm doing. I am working. There's going to be a quiz on this, guys. I'm working the seeds out. And I'm doing it under water, so I'm not putting it all over myself or the counter. Look how pretty these are.
I think that already happened.
They look like little jewels.
They are the little garnet jewels. And these are called arils. They're a seed, but then they've got a juicy pouch around the outside.
passion fruit. If you have to eat real passion fruit, mm-hmm. I like one of the best things.
So you can eat these, and we're going to be using these in our salad tonight. So that's what. So when you get done with all this, what we're going to do is we're going to strain off this stuff. This stuff we're not going to eat. This stuff comes off the top. And then we're just going to strain the seeds, dry them off, and that's going to be part of our salad or our garnish or whatever we're going to have with it. It's going to be with our pork. It's going to be with everything tonight.
Now, do you eat the whole seed part?
Yep.
Okay.
Here, yep.
It's like a passion fruit. Not just part.
Super easy to do. Little burst of flavor. Very tangy, and it's going to be really awesome in the salad. We're going to also have it with the pork, and we can also put it on top of the bacon and stuff.
It's very good in mojitos.
And it's awesome in mojitos.